हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, डेली डिक्टेशंस के लिए और आपके डाउट्स के सॉल्यूशंस के लिए इस चैनल को अभी सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन प्रेस करें ताकि आपको चैनल से जुड़ी सभी अपडेट्स रेगुलरली सबसे पहले मिल सके। दोस्तों, प्रीवियस ईयर की डिक्टेशंस की सीरीज़ को आगे बढ़ाते हुए आज ग्रेड डी का एक और मैटर आपको प्रोवाइड करूंगा मैं। ग्रेड सी के सारे मैटर फिनिश हो चुके हैं, सो अब ग्रेड डी का मैटर मेरे पास दो या तीन मैटर बचे हुए हैं। सो 800 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है। इस वीडियो में मैं आपको 100 वर्ड पर मिनट पर डिक्टेशन दूंगा और अगली वीडियो आपको मैं डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड करूंगा 80 वर्ड पर मिनट की। सो आपको डिक्टेशन मैं प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं, बी रेडी फॉर इट। सर, बिफोर आई स्पीक ऑन द मोशन इटसेल्फ, I wish to suggest that since this is the last day of the session, we might probably devote the whole day in discussing the principles that have been placed before us. The house knows, sir, that we have left many things incomplete. Many reports have been presented to us and we have only dealt with parts of them. A good many sections of the recommendations of the committee have been left out for further consideration. I submit, sir, that this should not happen to this particular report. The report, in my opinion, is the most important of all because it represents that part of the constitution which the masses of India are looking forward to for the fulfillment of the promises made to them by their leaders. Everyone is watching as to how far we are serious in our promises to ameliorate their condition and make better the standard of living of the average man. From that point of view, I submit that this particular portion of the Constitution should be given more importance than the other parts of it. Every opportunity should be given to the members to express themselves. I would further submit that the recommendations should not be taken into consideration in this session if the criticisms that I wish to level are going to have any effect on this. In this case, I do not know whether we shall be able to go to the people and tell them that we are striving to protect their interests not only temporarily but permanently also. My first criticism against the present report is that it is exceptionally official in nature. The attitude of the members of the committee is very correctly reflected in the way the report is written. I submit to you and to the House, sir, that this is not the correct attitude to take when dealing with fundamental rights of the Constitution. India is totally incomparable with any other country in this regard. In my opinion, the committee viewed the whole question from an utterly wrong standpoint. It appears to me that our framers of the Constitution have merely studied the existing constitutions and choose what they thought would probably serve as a soap to us. This, I think, summarizes in a nutshell what has been presented to us. They did not want, in any case, to go very far. But nonetheless, they were not in a position to leave out the social and economic aspects of the Constitution altogether untouched. They have dealt with it in a half-hearted manner. Therefore, this cannot be accepted by a very large section of people, either here or outside. We expected, sir, that the Indian society would in the future be regulated on definite principles. What are the principles that have been embodied here? One of the principles is that people have a non-justiciable right to a means of livelihood. It is a matter of common knowledge, and any modern government would be ashamed not to own what has been embodied here. It is the absolute minimum that every modern constitution and government must declare. We do not want to hollow declaration. We may not insist upon the maximum also, and I am prepared for a compromise. But we do not want to depend on mere platitudes and pious wishes. At least since the early years, the character of the ruling party has altogether changed. The change was due to the fact that there was a solemn promise that the government of India would be that of the peasants and workers of India. That was what implied so many rural people and youths to sacrifice their lives for the attainment of independence. If you analyze the figures, you will be startled to find that none of the vested interests sacrificed their lives. And those who sacrificed were purely the backward and illiterate people from the rural communities. That being so, it is our duty to look to the promises that we had held out, and we should have kept that ideal in view while considering the report. We should not have tried merely to make half-hearted recommendations. Let the people of India be given a definite program. Instead of all that, we are merely going to hold out some distant and indistinct hope without any effective means as to when and how they are going to be realized. I submit that it will be far better if we utilize the time between this session and the next session for reconsideration of the recommendations in the light of the criticism that may be leveled against the report on the floor of this house. We may then hope to have something better than what we have here today. So, दोस्तों dictation की speed थी 100 word per minute की, 800 words की dictation है, 8 minutes में finish हुई है, और उम्मीद करता हूँ आप लोगों ने अच्छा ही लिखा होगा, और skill test अच्छे ही आ रहा है, parliamentary matters ही हैं, आपने previous year की अगर series कर रखी है, जो मैंने upload की है पूरी, so आपको कोई दिक्कत नहीं आने वाली exam में, similar kind of dictations आपको मिलेंगी, और बहुत अच्छा arrangement है, जैसा कि मैंने live session में बताया है, so आपसे मैं मुलाकात करूँगा अगली video में 80 word per minute के साथ, इसी matter की, तब तक के लिए, bye bye, take care.